Your turn. She won't talk to
me.
You have exhausted my friend Uba here, but I'm wide awake. Maybe tell me where Burkrit is hiding and let him rest happy.
Never.
Stone-faced and tight-lipped. All for a king who hides like a cowardly vole, too scared to protect his family and his people. Thirsty?
My husband does what he must for Mercia. How could he do otherwise, knowing that even his closest friends could betray him? Give that traitor Ceowulf my message. He may win this earthly battle, but the devil has won the war for his soul.
He stabbed you in the back, true. But the people of Mercia are scared, and Ceowulf offers them a balm for that fear.
I spit on him. Whatever life he makes in Mercia will be built on the graves of the nobles who gave their lives to defend it.
The longer you drag this out, the truer that becomes. We've taken Repton, Tamworth, now Templebroth, and Leicester. With each victory, your hope for peace recedes.
Yet Borgred has what you do not. The loyalty of his people. Good men. Faithful men.
Who? The Thanes and Chills of Mercia? No, no. Only Leofrith remains loyal, and he too will fall.
Yes, goodly Leofrith. He will die defending his king. And win or lose, he will send 100 more of you to hell.
Eivor, your ladyship? Do not mind me, only here to count my spoils.
Oh, God!
Out, Ivar. Now.
All right, all right. But if you mean to stay, mind the smell after they finish this.
My God! Get me out of here! Please!
Talk now, and we'll draw you a nice warm bath.
You are asking me to betray my husband. How can I do that?
If you don't, you will betray countless others. In legend, you may be remembered as the king and queen who abandoned their kingdom in its darkest hour. But there will be peace. This is Ceowulf's promise, and it will be honored. You have my word.
Does the caged bird sing?
Burkrit is hiding, in an old crypt to the south, where the Olney and Arrow rivers join.
A crypt? Now tell me this is not a sign from the gods.
It's a long way to carry a king. The three of you must clear a path back to Tamworth. Where can we meet?
Bring him to the bridge at Venonus. It's a straight line through. We'll deal with any trouble there.
The heads were a nice touch. I'm not one for spectacle, but it got her talking.
Spectacle? That's just me.
Thank you.
Your bakery's done, Tavin. And our feasting table will be warmer for it.
Eivor, that is kind of you. I hope one day I can repay you.
You are among friends here. There's no need.
No need, but a desire. An earnest one. I remember the good things people do for me. To warm my heart in times when kindnesses are few and far between. There was one more thing, though. If you had a moment. A grain merchant has set up downriver. I want to bring a half dozen bags home. But I would need an extra pair of hands.
I can lend a hand.
That's a relief. I did not fancy asking Holger.
Tarbin, what brought you to our clan?
Your reputation. Heard folk say a band of hard-drinking, battle-scarred warriors had washed up on shore. Said you had settled in the center of Mercia, taking in whatever flotsam, jetsam, and jumble of misfits came to your docks.
And this appealed to you?
More than anything. Always been a bit of a drifter. The thought of settling in a rowdy camp felt like a good balance. I knew my services would not be sniffed at.
I did not take you for a baker when we met. You have the look of someone who swings an axe.
I do hear that a lot.
But baking is your only craft, is that right?
I have always enjoyed it. And I have always been good at it. But when I'm not able to find such work, I take odd jobs where I can. So long as I can work with my hands.
Well, we have that in common.
A question, Eivor. You're a warrior, a fighter. That much I know. But if you could stop fighting, what would you do?
You ask the wrong question. I can stop fighting. But to do so would be to deny the essence of who I am. I think you mean, if I had to stop fighting, what would I become?
No, you've given me the answer I wanted. It's good you found what calls you. A rare and happy thing.
Yes, yes, I see you both. What can I... It's you. What are you doing in Mercia?
Collecting grain. 30 silvers worth, if you can spare it. I do have the coin.
Right. Well, take what you need and get going.
That should cover it. Thank you kindly.
Of course. And you, you take good care of yourself. Yeah?
Is that your usual vendor? He seemed a little surprised to see you.
Did he? Well, could be he knows somebody who looks like me. There's no shortage of big bearded men around here, yeah?
I suppose not. About your question earlier, what would I do if I weren't a warrior? I would ask the same of you. Is baking bread your greatest wish?
Is there something wrong with wanting to bake bread? The Romans baked bread. The Egyptians baked bread.
It is a fine trade. But is it your calling?
It is my calling to feed people, I'd say. To be of service to those I care for.
Put that way, it is a noble pursuit.
I don't know that it's noble. It is simply what gets me up in the morning. It gives me purpose for the rest of my day.
Need help with your grain?
No need, no need. I'll do the rest myself. Bring it in and put it where I like.
All right. It was good to speak with you, Tarpin. A welcome diversion.
You too, Eivor. Thank you for your help.
Thank you, Eivor. This is the place we needed.
Thought up a few new ones for you.
What have you got for me today?
All right, if you're done.
I must take my leave. So long.
So long.
To true poetry, compare.
May I see your stores?
You like the looks of that one? My pieces are good, but that one's very good. Is that what you want? There, better than before. I can get you that one easy. That one's pretty good. This will serve you well. You have a keen eye for quality. Ah, look at you. Wonderful.
you like the looks of that one? Done for now.
I'm off. Be well, friend.
Until next we meet.
Eivor, what a pleasure to see you.
Ha ha ha.